Imagine and believe are words we use often. As artists, we like the sentiments they convey. Today, we're going to make banners that spell out these messages. We'll use wool, felt, and fabric to make the individual pennants, then we'll add some stitching to complete the look. Join me to have some fun. These are some of the pennants for our banner. Previously, I made one that spells out the word believe, and that's some of what you see here. However, all of the pennants are reused in the Imagine banner. We're just going to swap the letters so that it spells out Imagine. And I will give you templates that explain which letter belongs on which pennant so that you get them and they fit properly, because some of them have been made very big to take up all of the room on the pennant. There'll be diagrams and patterns that you can use. This is the pennant to make the letter N in Imagine. I'm going to trace around this, and this is just a pit pen. I'm going to cut just to the inside of this line, so it's not going to matter that I'm using a pen on here. I'm not going to see the marks after the fact. Once I get this traced, I'm going to cut it out, and then we're going to move on to cutting out the actual letter N. Again, if you cut just to the inside of that line, no one will ever be the wiser that you used a permanent pen. And there's our pennant. Here is our letter N. I'm going to do the same thing on this one as I did on the wool felt, which is to come in and just trace around the outline. This is going to be raw edge applique, so there's no seam allowance, there's no turn under, there's no nothing. It's just straight cutting. Now that we have a pennant and we have a letter to go with it, the next step is going to be to blanket stitch around the edge of the pennant. This is how I start the blanket stitch, and quite honestly, if you looked in a book about how to blanket stitch, this is probably me doing it totally wrong, but this is how I do it, and if you want to do it this way, that's great. If not, check the book and find a better way. I don't want to have a knot on the back of the pennant, so I'm going to run my needle up the side so that it comes out the top here. And I'm just going to pull it till the tail's inside, and then I'm going to start stitching. And I'm going to hold this here to make certain that as I make this first stitch, I'm not going to pull my little end out. And again, this is how I do a blanket stitch. What I like about this DMC Color Variations floss is the color change that happens as you stitch. This happens to be one that changes from teal to turquoise to blue, and I think it works really well with this pennant. And when you get this done, once you go all the way around, you'll have something that looks like this. You can see the color change here. And then once it's finished, the next step will be to attach the letter. I have my eye pennant and I blanket stitched all around the edges, so the next step is to sew the letter I on. I've pinned the body of the I, and all I'm going to do is attach this with a running stitch. Now, I don't want a knot on the back of the pennant, so I'm just going to come up here in the corner, and then I'm going to bury the end of the thread between the eye and the felt, and then just running stitch all the way around this. A little bit crooked there. pull it out over here. And then clip this off flush, and it will disappear inside. I'm going to do the same thing with the dot on the eye, and then I'm going to show you how we're going to couch the cordae twist on here, and that's what we're going to use to string our banner together. I've pinned my cordae twist in place. Be sure when you do this that you leave enough ends on both sides so that you can space the pennants out if you want. So I'm going to come through here and just bury the end of this thread in the felt, and then I'm just going to take little couching stitches all the way across to hold the cordae twist in place. You're going to do this all the way across, cut the end off, and then call it done.